On a dirt airstrip in western Kenya stands one of the region's best hopes that its dairy industry can take off.
If the business in charge of this plane has its way, cow will be delivering embryos as far as Rwanda, 900 kilometres away, Tanzania and other parts of Kenya. The life of an embryo lasts only 36 hours at maximum, so they have a very short window to get them across the region. And this could be the plane that does it.
The brainchild behind the plan to transport the cow embryos is Tim Chizire, a Kenyan farmer who wants to transform his country's $2 billion dairy sector. From January, for the first time in East Africa, his company Indicus plans to fertilise the embryos of high-yielding dairy cows in his on-site laboratory and then implant them into hardy surrogates across the region. The idea is to maximise both the accessibility and affordability of high-milk-producing cattle. I visited him at his dairy farm, which also grows seed maize, to hear his plan and to meet the cows.
These are the kind of cattle you transplant the embryos into. So these are the recipient cattle, the surrogates.
Why?
They carry the pregnancy. Because this is it's a cheaper animal to find. They're very, very, they're in very big numbers across Kenya. So, and I can buy one for about 40, 30,000 bob, which is, what, $300 to $400, which makes it very affordable. Whilst the pedigree cattle go for, at the moment, I sell for about $3,000 a heifer. So there's 17 million of these across Kenya, and they form about 90% of all the cattle we have. So it's a cheap way to propagate as many dairy heifers as possible.
For Mr. Chizire, the Ayrshire cow has the answer to Kenya's problem of low milk output.
I'm sitting next to some of the finest bred Ayrshire cows in Kenya. They date back to a line 45 years ago from Scotland, and they can produce up to 30 litres a day of milk. Now that's massive compared to the Kenyan average of 4 litres a day.
Mr. Chizire tells me it usually takes 7 generations to breed a pedigree cow that can produce up to 30 litres a day. But his genetic technology can leapfrog all this, and for a third as much as it costs to buy a fully grown Ayrshire cow.
This is in many ways a leapfrog technology for Kenya. We can be able to remove the eggs from quality cattle such as these, the young heifers, fertilize in vitro, as I talked about, and transfer them onto very poor quality cattle. It's a leapfrog technology in the sense that these poor quality cattle will immediately birth high quality pedigree heifers.
And you were saying normally it would take 8 generations?
It would take about 7 generations for you to get a pedigree.
Although Kenya's cows traditionally produce very little milk, it has so many cows that, at 4.7 billion litres of production last year, Kenya still produces more than any other African country. That, along with double-digit growth in the dairy sector, has turned the eye of foreign investors such as Dubai's Abraj private equity outfit and Europe's Danone, which are both investing heavily in Kenyan agribusiness.
And tell me about the idea of adding value in agribusiness. Is this something that you're noticing outside investors are now beginning to see milk as a sector that really competes as an investment prospect?
I think so. I think recently it was announced that Danone, one of the largest processors in Europe, a French processor, has just bought into Brookside, which is the largest private processor. When you look at the sums that were involved, when you look at the interest being shown by other processors, Dutch processors trying to come in, Italian processors trying to come into the country, it tells you that the sector is maturing and is eventually actually reaching the potential that it was destined to.
If Mr. Chizire is right, the country's 300,000 dairy farmers really could one day see Kenya become the New Zealand of Africa. For the Financial Times, in Eldoret, this is Katrina Manson.